Hello, Clamp K here. Welcome back to Thea the Awakening. Don't remember what. They're not in camp yet. They're out of move, so we're good there. So at this point, I think we're gonna end turn, and I think we're headed off to the Cosmic Tree or thereabouts. Yeah, we can't use coal for that, so we do need to get some stone or clay, bones, more wicker. Let's actually go ahead and turn wicker. Good, wicker is off for burning. Turn that fruit on. So Expedition 1. Travel north of the Cosmic Tree. We'll attack the skeletons. Oh, this might have been a mistake. Well, keep in play. Counter one of the tactics. I probably actually should have just played that one. Now that I think about it. We'll stick that one in ahead. Stick that one in. That ends up being beneficial to me. Start with our wolf. Closer. Kill that one. Can we win this? If we go first, maybe. But the opponent goes first. They start with that one. Which means I kill this guy, I lose to this one. Or I lose to this. Yeah, I lose. I screwed up on that first turn.
Wounds don't always have a chance to heal, and so death.
Now I really need to go back to Stoy.
Today was a good harvest day, and some of the village folk even managed to brew some samagon. A A strong spirit, not for the weak-hearted.
Let us drink
the
now.
The Simurgh kicks in like a speeding troll ramming itself into your head. You collapse into your beds in hopes of sleeping it off. At night, a nasty little demon, Gnichia, is attracted by your libations. The creature rests on top of your chests, squeezing the air out and meddling with your minds, trying to take your willpower to feed itself. It is making your heads hurt and your guts turn and twist.
Maybe we can do this one. Let's reshuffle. That looks better. It is our turn. We will start. Maria. Alright, we definitely want to counter a tactic this turn. Stick in Janna. Effect. And I'll tell everyone else to get in closer because this should guarantee you a win. Kills that one. Actually, we'll end here. This should do it. Oh, I forgot about that tactic that we got rid of.
You fought off the nasty Gnichia, and although you feel sick the next morning, it is nothing more than the usual hangover. The whole village actually feels healthier after you defeated the demon, and you discover its body has turned into precious stones.
Ooh, some topaz.
The fight with the demon left some of you feeling stronger in your willpower.
And Maria is stronger. Shouldn't have done that. We're gonna want to retreat. Hopefully she lives, which she does.
Pigeon flies to your village with a note attached. It reads, "Dear residents of the lovely settlement, if you will, please visit my humble abode placed not so far from your lovely home. It is very nice. I am a blacksmith of dwarven tradition, and I have an offering for you, kind people. Yes, there is a small map drawn in strange purple glowing ink."
I think we will check this out at some point. Go home. View it, village. Where do I see my population? I have forgotten. put Yanya there. Construction. Yeah. Still out of luck there. Let's burn a couple of turns. Fight with some spiders. Yeah, that's fine. Keep in play. Spider Queen goes first. We're gonna get closer with Yanya, and then have Eliska get close as well. End our turn there. Can we can shield? Could also first action. Send Zoltania. First action her. Send out Janna. Yeah, we'll get closer for both of them and just call it there. That should wipe out the first two spiders. Get those two spiders. And now we knock out their tactics, all three of them. We got a lucky button. Create a new expedition. You want Yanya, Bogdala, and Rosov? Lucky button to Bogdala. Oh, that would increase her too much. So we'll give her one of those. You can take the lucky, cannot take the lucky button. Two-handed. Don't want equipped. Yeah, we're fine with that. Oh, I misread that. Call that there. Take 14 logs. Three food, that's fine. Because we're going to the smithy.
Hidden away in a quiet alcove, you discover a single house amongst ruins of some old town. There is smoke coming from the chimney and the sound of hammering inside. This is clearly a smithy. You notice an unusually large pile of rocks sitting by the house.
Go to the house.
As you approach, the hammering stops and a dwarf walks out to greet you.
That's far enough, strangers. You do not want to anger Chael, she gets very jumpy, that one.
The pile of rocks opens its eyes and stares at you. It's definitely a rock troll.
We're definitely not gonna fight, so we're just passing by. We got your invite.
Hey, your village, aye. Well, truth be told, I move around me, and I don't like trust any stranger coming to see me. Unless I want you to, you will not find your way here, hence the invite. And this brings me to why you did find me. I have a wee problem, and if you help, I will give you a full set of armor with some good weapons and all. You see, I've got me a kind of, well, a female problem. Ah, well, it's
what
kind
now?
Of embarrassing. You know, us fallen dwarves, that is, the ones who stayed behind when the darkness came, we tend to be solitary types, at least when it comes to females. After all, no dwarven woman chose this sad fate, at least not one I know of. In any case, the story cut short, there is a cute demon girl, the nice type, mind you, living nearby, and, well, I tried impressing her with my smithing, but she doesn't like weapons. I tried sweet talking, but turns out it ain't my best feature. So if you go and convince her to go out with me, I will give you the prize.
This sounds too good to be true, but sure, why not?
This is a serious matter, mind you. She can get a bit nasty if you're not careful, and I've been trying for decades now. Anyway, I don't know how much you do know of them water demons, but just try not to dance with her. And probably avoid going for a swim, and, well, just be careful. She's a sneaky one. Excellent. Here's a map of the local area. I marked roughly the spots where she hangs out, but I think she may be on the move with her sisters, so just, yeah, watch out.
Sisters? Whatever, fine. Off I go to convince the demon to date an old dwarf. Ooh, 3 XP. Alright, that's a bit off. I think we'll go back. We'll actually pick up someone else. We're gonna need wisdom. I think. Or intelligence, that's what will probably be needed. Low intelligence. Great willpower. I'll take Maria as well. Food should be enough. get some armor then. Off we go. Can we actually go ahead and make smoked meat? No, we're missing the vegetables and such. So we're stuck like that. Let's end it this turn. No, that spider pack's back. But we can go this way now. Avoiding the spider pack for now.
Approach the place shown by the dwarf, you see a girl sitting on a large rock, frantically looking out into the distance.
We'll approach her.
When she sees you, she runs over without a second thought for her own safety, and speaks with a voice so soft and melodic, you cannot help but listen. You look, well, I guess you look like, you can handle some ruffians, right?
We know she's a demon, so let's start, or we believe she's a demon, so we'll start with, hello lady. We've been sent here by a dwarf and smith to talk to you.
Dwarven smith? Oh, Bodan, him. But why are you bothering me with him? I have a real emergency on my hands. I had 4 children, my nieces, yes. I was going to take them home, and I was set upon by a band of orcs. They took the poor little ones. Oh, what will I do now?
You have 4 children on your own, out here?
I was on my way home. It's not too far from here, and we thought we were safe. Now there is no time to chat. We must find them now, and I would help, only I am so weak. These orc brutes have surely harmed my little ones. Oh, please help.
Find them if you're good to this dwarf.
What are you talking about? There are children at stake here. Yes, yes, I will do as you say. You must go now. I will mark on your map where I last saw them. Hurry.
And now we're after some orcs. More spiders. No. That's better. I'm gonna start by sending in Yanya. Bogdala to go first. That'll kill this one. Tree. Yeah, we'll be fine after that. Get closer. Now we'll see what happens here. Alright, that's not too bad. I'm hoping we go after the queen spider first. No. That's a bit of an irritant. So Maria is down. On a plus note, there goes the queen spider. Yep, that's fine. Oh, there's the surrender button. One, two, three. Yeah, we'll get closer. Poisoned. That might be it for him as well, but everything else is going to be dead. Because Bogdala here can easily hold her own against both these spiders. One, everyone's hurt. Can't set up camp there. Go here. Set up camp. Spend a couple of turns.
Don't always have a chance to heal, and so death can claim.
No, we lost Maria. It's gonna hurt a little bit. We have to sit though. Three wolves, we can handle three wolves. You're definitely not going out. So that's fine. Keep in play. Gonna start with Broslav. A wolf. A wolf. Eleven to kill. Gonna play Bogdala in the hopes that they go for her first. I didn't want to, but I think I have to now. Bogdala shall still be fine. Oops. So after this combat, we're going to go ahead and put in a break. Don't forget to hit the like button if you enjoyed this. Leave a comment down below if you have anything else to say. Don't forget to subscribe to see more, and I will catch you next time.